Hey, good morning. Monday, April 5th, 2021. How the heck are you guys today? What a beautiful Monday morning it is over here in Tower City, Pennsylvania. Excuse me. Let me put down some caffeine. And you do the same. Come on, let's go. Well, how was your Easter Sunday and Easter weekend for you people that had the extended Easter vacation for the weekend, that is, you know. Mine was quite eventful. I was down in Cape May and got some bittersweet news, you know. In one sense, I'm happy. And in the other sense, I'm kind of, I'm going to miss it, you know. I sold my camper down there in Cape May Courthouse, New Jersey, at King Nummy Trail Campground. It came up, there was a mother and daughter team that wanted to come down and look at it. And I ran down there. I made sure I was there for Saturday because my plans were to stay home this weekend, you know, for Easter over here in Tower City. But I made a quick trip down there, and every intention was just, I figured, okay, you know, they want to look at it, I'll show it to them, and we'll see what happens. Well, they walked through it, and they bought it right there, you know, which, you know, was kind of a godsend, I guess, you know. The good Lord was saying, well, Warzy, you know, shit or get off the pot. You know, make your mind up. What are you going to do? You know, and I had it for 10 and a half seasons. And out of the 10 and a half seasons, I had more enjoyable times with that camper and in that campground than not. You know, made a lot of nice friends down there, and I'm going to miss it down there. You know, I said goodbyes to a few of my friends down there, and I sent out goodbyes to other ones, my camper neighbors and camper family friends down there. So, you know, who knows? Maybe I'll get down there again sometime. The drive was just getting to be too much for this old geezer, you know. It's 4 hours down there. And for 10 and a half seasons, well, out of the 10 and a half seasons, probably eight of the camping seasons, eight, maybe seven, I was going down every weekend, at least every weekend, you know, during the camping season. And that, you know, in the beginning, we'd leave at 9, 10 o'clock Friday evening, and I'd drive us and get down there, and I'd be fine with it, you know. That's when I was a little bit younger. But as the years went on, it got a little tougher and tougher, and my partner, she didn't really care to drive, so it was just me driving, you know, 99.9% of the time. I don't recall her driving 1, 2, 3 times, you know. We'd pull over and sleep somewhere. Hey, you want to drive? No, I'm tired too. That kind of thing, you know. And, you know, if you would talk to her, she would say, yeah, but he always enjoyed driving. Well, yes, I did. But as I got older, not so much, especially at night. During the daytime, it's not bad. Excuse me. But nighttime, it bothers my eyes. It's just a little bit more stressful. But anyway, I sold that camper, and I do have my camper down there in I guess it's considered York County, but it's in the Lancaster area, in a little area or a community or a town, whatever you want to call it, called Holtwood, Pennsylvania, you know. So I got my fifth wheeler over there. That's 36 footer. It's basically a one-bedroom apartment. This thing is gorgeous. It's a holiday rambler. You know, it's set up really nice, you know. I have no complaints whatsoever. So I'm looking forward to that journey. And we'll see what happens, you know, with staying there and making new friends and connections in that campground. But I did get a call this morning before I get into my, you know, dabble here on my good morning video. I got a call this morning from a family friend of mine. And when I say family, they're friends, but they became family to me, if that makes any sense to you guys. I met them. They're from the Villas in New Jersey. And I met them by accident. I used to get my adult beverage in their store. The Villas Liquor Store, I think it's called, in Villas, New Jersey. And I was there one time, and they had a community yard sale. And I went to their community yard sale on their property there, and I bought a Weber kettle grill from the daughter, and that's how we basically struck up a relationship with the daughter, and then the mother and the husband, as I was, you know, just chatting away at this yard sale. After I bought the Weber kettle grill, I said to him, "Yeah, I'm a DJ." And the daughter, she kind of perked up and said, "Hey, Mom, this guy's a DJ, you know." And we talked for a little while, and I told him what kind of music I do, you know, oldies and Motown and things like that. And they basically hired me for a couple gigs already, you know. And we just got a connection of becoming friends. Well, anyway, Joyce, excuse me, the mother called me up this morning and said, "Hey, you moved on us. we seen on your Facebook posting that you sold your camper and you moved. What's going on?" So I called him back, and you know, I said, I explained everything to him. I said, yeah, you know, I sold it. "Well, we got to get you down here." I said, "Yeah, I know. I'm going to figure something out." I said, "It's funny that you say that, Joyce, because earlier this morning, I'm already looking for just a small Class C motorhome, you know, to do a little bit of traveling in it, you know, with whoever my partner might be down the road here, if I have a partner that wants to travel to other campgrounds with me." And, you know, I already made arrangements down there at King Nummy. You know, if I get a Class C, yeah, I'm going to go in there and, you know, stay for a weekend or whatever. And I already talked with a couple people at King Nummy that, hey, if you got, you know, your gigs coming up, I'm that guy, call me. I'll come down there and DJ it for you. And I told Joyce from the Villas Liquor Store, I told her the same thing, and she said, "Yeah, myself and my daughter, Tracy, we're going to have a party. We'll be in touch with you." I said, "Okay, yeah. Hey, I'm in. I'm there, you know." But it was nice to just have that feeling that, you know, somebody, you know, was fond enough of me to call up and say, "Hey, you know, we're going to miss you," kind of thing, you know. And I'm going to miss all those people too, but I'll get down there. Yeah, I will, because I love the Cape May area. Yes, I do. I've been going down there, you know, with my father, God rest his soul, since 1973. And actually, the first time I went down there was with a friend of mine, and it wasn't actually Cape May, but it was in that area. A buddy of mine, his name was Tom Malloy. They called him Tommy Malloy from Exton, Pennsylvania. We went down there. It might have been for a day trip or a weekend trip. I don't know. And we looked at a boat together. And I personally ended up buying a boat. And I went home and I told my mom and dad. And my dad said, "Jesus, I bought a boat? What the heck?" You know. And needless to say, that got him into the boating thing. I mean, he's always had little rowboats for fishing on lakes and things like that. But I got this little bit of a, if you want to say, a mini cabin cruiser. It was an Owens, and it was a wood boat. And, you know, it had a little cabin in it. It was a single screw. 318, I believe, was involved with it. And it was my my father that got involved, my brother Roy, and myself, and his partner at the time, and my partner at the time, and we had some good times with it. I think it was a 27 footer. I could be wrong, or maybe it wasn't that one. But anyway, it was a single screw, and I think we named it Lil Love. I think that was the name of that boat. L-U-L, Love, I think. And then we moved on from there and got bigger boats and better boats. And, you know, the rest became history. And then I had a motorhome, and we started doing camping around the, you know, the area of Cape May area, and stayed at a few campgrounds. And we latched on to King Nummy Trail Campground, and I got to know the owners of the campground there at the time, and I became their, if you want to say it, in-house DJ. I get a couple gigs a year out of them, pool parties, and that's how I made my friendship and relationships with my people in the Cape May area. It was quite an experience and quite an adventure. And then I moved on into DJing at other campgrounds in that general area. I'm just giving you a little bit of, you know, useless information about my history. I'm just talking so we can all enjoy our coffee together, you know? Okay, enough of that. I got 12 minutes into... I didn't even start on my video. But anyway, Joyce, it was a pleasure talking with you today. Give my love and hugs and kisses to the family, if you would, the big guy and your daughter, okay? And tell her that the Weber kettle, it's coming out. It's in my basement right now. It's coming out. It's time to bring it on out. Before I get on here, I got to tell you, Joyce, when I sold the camper, the mother said to me, what, you don't have a grill? I said, oh yeah, I got a grill, but I took it home with me last season. There was no way I was going to sell that camper with my Weber charcoal kettle grill. No. Okay, enough of that. And as I said, Joyce, make sure you say good morning to everybody for me, all right? Your sister and your brothers and of course the big guy and Tracy and, you know, everybody else. Let them know that I will be in touch and I'll be down there to see them, you know. Okay, today being Monday, April the 5th, let's go with some birthdays. It's Pharrell Williams' birthday, if you remember him. He did the hit song Happy, you know. He's a singer, he's a songwriter, and he's a fashion designer. I didn't know that. He's from, he was born in Virginia Beach, Virginia. His net worth right now is about $48 million. He was one of the judges on The Voice way back when. And his net worth is $200 million. So, Pharrell, happy 48th birthday, young man. Kudos to you. Another birthday today. Another fine gentleman, really. Mr. Colin Powell, you know. Happy birthday, Mr. Powell. You know, he's 84 years young today. His net worth is about $13.7 million. Let's say, round it up, his net worth is about $14 million, give or take. He was born in Harlem, New York. He's a Republican Party American politician. So, Mr. Colin Powell, happy birthday to you. Let's see here. We'll do a three-day weather forecast over there in Virginia Beach, Virginia, because of Pharrell Williams. That's where he was born, as I said, okay? Today in Virginia Beach, Monday, April the 5th, the high is going to be about 70 degrees. The low is going to be 54 and sunny. Tuesday in Virginia Beach, Virginia, 64 for a high, 53 for a low, and sunny again. Wednesday in Virginia Beach, 64 for a high, 54 for a low, and sunny again. So you got 3 days, three nice days, including today, if you want to do a road trip to Virginia Beach, you know, take out your camper, or even just your four-wheeler vehicle and go explore Virginia Beach. And I don't know if there's any campgrounds down in that area or not. I would think there is, you know. So have at it. Now, let's go over here to the area where my other camper's at. Well, I don't have other anymore. Where my camper is at. Holtwood, Pennsylvania. Monday, today, 66 for a high, 45 for a low, partly sunny. Tuesday in Holtwood, Pennsylvania, 69 for a high, 48 for a low, and sunny again. And Wednesday in Holtwood, Pennsylvania, the high is going to be 67, the low is going to be 47, and partly sunny. So, you know, if you're in the Holtwood area and just driving around, it's great countryside there, I'll tell you that, you know. You're in the muck, and I shouldn't say muck, but you're in Amish area there, you know. You got to watch out for the horse and buggy, which, you know, it's a beautiful area. It really is. And Holtwood is not far from, it's called the Buck, B-U-C-K, Pennsylvania, okay? Quarryville, Pennsylvania. You know, Holtwood is in that general area, if you ever get down that way. And Joyce, you know, if you're in that area, make sure you get in touch with me and Tracy, you know, and the big guy. Come down and, you know, give me a 24-hour notice and I'll meet you guys at the campground and I'll turn you on to a couple adult libations and I'll even have one of my Weber kettle grills down there, Tracy. Okay, today, over here in Tower City, Pennsylvania, 65 for a high. 42 for a low and sunny. And it's nice out there today. Nice this morning. And my buddy Sir Prince, he's still sleeping. You know? I got to wake him up here shortly and say, hey, come on. We got to go outside and go potty. I mean, he's usually up by now. Oh, there he is. I didn't even know he came out here. Okay, I got to make this short because he's sitting here patiently and he's waiting for me. Okay, today is National Gold Star Spouses Day. That's for all the widows out there that lost their loved ones, you know, serving our country, you know. So if you know any Gold Star widows out there, you know, give them a hug and a kiss and, you know, make sure you thank them for having somebody in their family that served our country, okay? God bless them. It's also a National Flash Drive Day, you know. If you're into the flash drives, today's your day to celebrate and say, hey, National Flash Drive Day. See mine? I don't know. And it's also National Caramel Day. Caramel, whatever. I'm not a big caramel eater, but it's National Caramel Day. You know, get yourself a couple pieces of caramel if you're into it and pop it in your mouth there and enjoy it, you know. Today is also National Read a Roadmap Day. How many of you people are still reading roadmaps? I have one. I still have one. A Rand McNally. It's kind of outdated, obviously, but I still carry it around with me religiously. I would always have one in my motorhome, even though, you know, you can do everything right now on Google Maps and that, but it's always nice to be able to read a roadmap. And you got to wonder if these young people that are out there, and when I say young people, let's say from maybe 32 years of age and younger, how many can actually read a map anymore, you know? Something to think about. And it's also national, Deep Dish Pizza Day. If you're into the deep dish pizzas, I'm not. I like a very paper-thin pizza, and it's got to be, it's got to have gluten in it, all right? Got to have that pull to it, and real mozzarella cheese on it. I like a sausage pizza, and it's got, like I said, it's got to be paper-thin. But that's just my humble opinion. It's also National Go for Broke Day. Well, I'm right there. I am broke. Yes, I am. But I'm happy. Let's put it down one more time. Come on, people. Cheers. Nastrovia. Lakhaim. And salute. Come on. That's all I have today, folks. I know I'm a little long-winded. I got 22 minutes into this good morning video. If you like my video, do me a favor. Hit that like button. Share it with your friends and family. If you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to my channel. And encourage your family members, friends, whatever, to subscribe to my channel. I do my best to make a good morning video Monday through Friday. And obviously, you can watch it at any time of the day you want. Once you subscribe to my channel and you hit the customize button, that way you'll be notified every time I make one. And you can watch it at your leisure, whether it's going to be first thing in the morning, afternoon, evening after work, late evening, just to chill out, relax, and just ignore what's going on out there, you know, in TV land, you know, with the news and that. That's it, my friends. Have a great day today. And Joyce, again, you know, it was fine having a good morning chat with you today. Give my love to everybody. Debbie, a.k.a. Reds, over there in King Nummy. Jeff, good morning to you, you know. And all my King Nummy friends, good morning to you guys. Even though I'm not there, I'm there in spirit. Stay in touch with me. Send me a message every now and then. Let me know what's going on, okay? Keep me current on all the news down there. Fran, good morning to you. I'm sorry I didn't get to say adios to you also. You know, hopefully we'll run into one another again, and I'm sure we will. And my buddy Stevie and Karen, sorry I missed you guys. Nancy, good morning to you. All right, guys, take care. And all my King Nummy friends, I'm not slighting you guys, okay? Good morning to you. Stay in touch with me. To my family members, my son, my daughter-in-law, my nieces, nephews, grandchildren, my brothers, my sister, okay, my brother-in-law, brother-in-laws, good morning to you. I hope all you guys are healthy, safe, and well. And Nicholas, get well, my friend, okay? Take care of yourselves. Tina, good morning to you. Cheers in Nastrovia. Good morning, Kaylee. And your card is in the mail. It'll be delivered to your mom's house, okay? Here we go. Gonna punch you out on three. Take care of one another. God bless all of you. Stay healthy and safe. And don't forget to smell the coffee. Okay? Enjoy yourself. God bless you. I'll see you again. Take care. One, two. Oh, and happy birthday to anybody that's having a birthday today. How's that for a happy birthday? Uh-huh. Here we go. Big smile. One, two. You're going out. Peace. See ya.